Yeah, pretty minimalist setup. We're actually leaving barefoot. We're going to leave our stuff here. We're going to go let the owners know that we're going to leave for a little while. We're going to go over to Colorado Bend, and we're going to backpack tonight. We're going to spend the night in the middle of the woods. We just don't know which side of the park we're going to do it on. So we're over there to go see about that.
Welcome to this episode of State Parkers.
Today we got some serious trail hiking ahead of us with some serious new gear. We're looking forward to showing you what that is, so stay tuned as we make our way to Bad Bob's Bend store, resupply, and get ready for this overnighter.
This is a very special adventure. You see, we've been told there's a wise man lurking about the woods at Colorado Bend State Park. We're gonna see if we can find him.
We were really looking forward to some ice cold beverages from the headquarters here, but we got in and it's cash only for the drinks. We didn't have any cash on us, so we have to come out to the truck and scrounge through some change that we have in a box. Came's in handy.
Well, I'm sporting a Aura 50 anti-gravity pack.
Brand new? How's it feel?
Feels great. Definitely feels good. It's pretty loaded down. But it doesn't feel as heavy as it should.
I myself picked up the Aether 60. Just doing some exploring today right now. We're heading down into the car camping area of Colorado Bend State Park. We'll see what we see. It's a beautiful day for hiking. Beautiful day for sightseeing. Beautiful day for everything. Look who we found. How are you?
Doing very well.
Excellent.
Hi, yeah. Good to meet you.
Good to meet you too. Oh. And so it's 6 feet by 10 feet and it costs about $14 from Walmart. And it is waterproof, guaranteed as by this rain. And then I just lift the side up, get in, and there's no problem in terms of, it's always ventilated because the ventilation goes through. And if it gets too hot, I just lift one side up.
Awesome.
Last night, I got a little bit chilly last night, and so I took just a little blanket on the inside and put it next to me.
There you go. I didn't even bring a sleeping bag tonight. I'm just gonna lay there and feel the wind blowing on me.
I wonder what these things are.
Oh,
here.
Those are little solar panels.
Solar panels. What are they charging up?
They charge up our lights.
Okay, cool. Light. Excellent.
Run all night
nice.
Long.
They'll run on low power for about. Was it 12 hours? It charges for 7 hours in direct sun.
You put it in the back of your
Or even indirect sun, it works pretty well.
Lumen-Aid?
Yeah, Lumen so on the lowest nice. Setting, it goes, and then it has a blinking setting, too.
That is awesome.
Well, excellent. Right. Well, this has been an awesome encounter. Found the wise man we were looking for. We were looking for a wise guy in the woods.
Wise guy.
So, all right, guys.
You have a good one.
Appreciate you, Ken. Jonathan. Y'all have a good camp. Have a safe drive back to Conroe.
Yep.
All right, we'll go half that distance. Well, that was fun running into Kenneth Kramm on the trail, him and his son Johnathan. Watch his channel. He's got some really informative videos. As you saw, he's got a really nice way of hanging a hammock right off the ground where it's still comfortable, and it rained an inch last night. He didn't get wet, so there you go. He's a pretty smart guy. All right, we're going to head out to the Spicewood Springs Trail and take a dip. Even if there's people there, I don't care. We're going to barge right on in. We're going to be loaded with our backpacks, and we're just going to come in there and look like hikers.
After that, we're going to head out to the Windmill Trail and backpack to our campsite. Looking forward to it.
It's time to take a dip. We made it back to the truck. We're gonna cool off, plan our next move. The store was closed. Thank you, Bob, for being closed on us. Anyway, always closed when we need you. Anyway, we're gonna get ready to go hike into some backpack camping. Enjoy ourselves in the middle of the woods section of this park we've never seen before. We are excited about that.
So the park seems pretty full today. I wonder if we're going to be the only ones out there or if we're going to have some neighbors.
I guess when we have neighbors, we make the best of it. And they usually end up giving us stuff.
Vice versa, too. We usually share.
Yeah.
We're on our way to Windmill Trail to start our first in a while overnight backpacking trip.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be a good trip. A little tiring, heavy packs, but we need the practice, so yeah. Going to say goodbye to the truck for the evening as we meander our way through the trails of the Windmill Trail system.
Lush and prickly.
We gotta be real quiet and still. We've come across two wild pigs. Now, we don't know if their babies are with them or not. But they can be aggressive. Not always. They're kind of unpredictable. We have to go that way. The pigs are right over here. So we're gonna slowly try to maintain a slow speed. Very quiet. You gotta love wildlife. There is a jackrabbit over there on the other side of that little tree. Somebody had the strength and courage to hike in with their own firewood. That's pretty cool.
Well, thank you.
How convenient. Sign right there says ground fires prohibited. We have a plan, however. We're gonna have a contained fire in a metal dish. It's not gonna leave a trace.
We found another little area. We're gonna go check it out real quick.
This is perfect.
Work. The trees are alive. They are evenly spread. I think we did it, ladies and gentlemen.
Always look for a previously used campsite so you don't destroy anything else unnecessarily. We'll see you in just a few. Stay tuned. Just for the record, this fire pit was here when we got here. So tonight we're not going to have a ground fire, but we're going to have a contained fire on this plate right here. We're just going to do a couple experiments and see if we can master the art of using a sparker or a flint striker to, you know, naturally start a fire with some kindling, just for fun. Now, it's really windy today. The only thing we really have to work with here is dried up leaves. They smoke a lot, but that's okay. This is just a test to see if we would be able to pull this maneuver off in the event of an emergency or if we really had to. It's not easy. I expect us to spend quite a bit of time tinkering with this, trying to get it to light, but that's okay. Okay, so there's our little pile of tinder. We're gonna see if we can make this work. I know I'm probably doing this wrong. There's a lot of you out there that know how to do this a lot better than I do. But we'll see what happens. Little trick I learned from Bob 808 Night. Pull away from the striker so you don't push forward and knock your stuff all over the place like I've been doing. Try that. Pull back. You still get a good spark. And we got it. Let the wind blow on that a little bit.
Good job.
Add a couple twigs. This will help keep some of the bugs away as well. We have a little bit of off, but we didn't bring a lot. Hey, check out Melody over here. Getting cozy in her hammock.
Tonight all we have are our hammocks and thermarests.
Ever wonder what that noise is you hear at night in the woods? There it is. Very interesting. Good morning. Today is day number 2 here at Colorado Bend / Barefoot Campground. We are camped over there. We woke up early this morning, broke down our hammocks. We're getting our stuff loaded so we can head on back to the car and go explore some more of this place.
Never seen this part of the park before. This is pretty cool.
Ant freak out.
Oh my god. Oh my god, that burns so bad. Whoo! Alright.
Well, are they still in your shoes?
I don't know.
Yeah. Oh god. Take them and just throw them on the ground. Knock all the ants off. It's gonna be an awesome day here at Colorado Bend. That is Fire Ant Bite City right there.
Oh yeah, got you there too.
Well, this looks like a job for first aid 2.2.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna go through and try to figure out if it's got any itch cream in it.
Right on the top.
Afterbite, the anti-itch.
I'm sorry that happened to you.
Me too. But you know what? When you're out here in their world, it's to be expected, you know?
Well, it's always a shame when we go search for a geocache and we can't find it, but it doesn't break our hearts that much because we got a lot more interesting things to do for the rest of the day. Right now, we just gotta safely get out of this without getting eaten by something, and back on the trail. Well, look at there. We made it back to the Parker Mobile. Awesome. Thank you, Windmill Trail System. Melody's back there taking a couple final shots of that trail so we can get on up the road, go visit Bob, get us a cheeseburger or something. Well, we're here at Bad Bob's Bin Store. We got some coffee. We're having them make us a nice cheeseburger so we can get full. And, carry on with our day.
I'm really looking forward to that cheeseburger.
There it is. Oh,
thank
there's
you.
Onions on the grilled one, right?
Okay.
So this is the North Face Mica 2 tent that we got from North Face. Put a little work into it. Made a really nice little video for the North Face Mountain Athletics apparel line, and in exchange for our hard work, we received a few items. It's pretty cool. Got some duffel bags, tent, sleeping bag on the way. So things are going good for state parkers right now. We feel like it's an appropriate part of the day to give you a little time lapse action. Rickety old thing. It says welcome. Come on in. Alright, so I'm gonna try to set it up in here. I'd say this is as good of a swimming spot as any out here.
If not the best.
So we're being wimps. We're sitting in the truck, blowing the AC on us because it's just quite hot outside. As nighttime as it is.
Yeah, it's 9:20 p.m. Still pretty light outside, and still hot outside. There's no breeze. Storm's not coming through, I guess. So, what now? Well, I guess it's about that time. Fire's dying out. So are we. So we're gonna hit the old tent here. Wake up tomorrow morning. Pack it up. Go to work. Thank you for joining us. It's been an awesome time.
We did Barefoot Campground. Then we did Colorado Bend State Park. And guess what? We got to meet Ken Kramm and his son Johnathan. Bushcraft in nature. Check out Ken Kramm's YouTube channel. It's awesome. You'll learn a lot from him. Alright,
Until the next time, I'm Clint.
I'm Melody. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also find us on Facebook and Instagram.
And don't forget, get out and go camping.